Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and we've been using Fabric for a while. You can create private data sets in the web with Fabric, but what we want to do is we want to use other tools, things like REST APIs and Tabular Editor, DAX Studio, SSMS, Visual Studio to connect to that model. You couldn't do that before, but now Microsoft just announced where you can do XMLA read-write operations against your Direct Lake dataset, and it's so exciting. So enough of all this talking. You know what we like to do? Let's do what? Head over to my laptop. So what you can do is you can go to Management Studio, choose Analysis Services, pop your workspace name in. It's just like Power BI. Go over to your workspace, go to workspace settings, click on premium, scroll to the bottom, and you see your workspace connection. This is your XMLA endpoint. You need to copy this. You need to make sure that you've went into your tenant settings and enabled XMLA read write. And if not, you'll need to get your tenant admin to go enable it. Once you've done that, you click connect. It'll go through authentication if you hadn't authenticated already, and boom, we'll be connected. There's the models that's in my workspace. I can look at the connections. I can look at the tables. As I expand this out, you can see there's my tables right there. And you know, it's all there. But what people really want is to do some pro development. They want to integrate with Git and do CI/CD. And Tabular Editor is a great place to do this. Let me show you. I'm going to hold on to that workspace connection, the XMLA endpoint. I'm going to go ahead and leave Management Studio for now. Go to Tabular Editor, open it up. You see right here where it says open data model from DB. Go ahead and click that, pop your workspace connection in, click OK. You'll be prompted to do some authentication. We'll get connected up. There we go. We're going to choose our XMLA model. That's the one we're going to work with. Click OK. And there's my model. Now, let's say someone's created this data model for us. And then we give people access and say, go create your own report. So they go create report. And they took a look. And they go, wait, Patrick. Why didn't you create any explicit measures for us? We don't want to use these implicit measures. We gave you specific things that we wanted. Why hadn't the measures been created? I was like, oh, hang on one second. First thing I need to do is turn off these implicit measures. And you may be so inclined to go into the model and then check, do it. But let me show you how you can do this really easily with Tabular Editor. I'm going to start in Tabular Editor 2. I think I opened 3, but I'm going to start in 2. And let's get connected one more time. And so there's my XMLA model again. And I'm going to click on my model, and then I'm going to sort this alphabetically just so I don't have to like go and look for all these things. There's a property called discourage implicit measures. I'm going to turn it to true because I don't want implicit measures in my model. And then I'm just going to click save. This will save the changes back to the connected database. And then I'm going to go back over to the web browser where my report is, and I'll refresh and I'll expand this out. Okay, so now, great, Patrick. Now we don't have any implicit measures, but we need some measures. All right, okay. So I can go in the web browser and do this, but watch this. I'm going to go to the table here, my fat cap rise, new measure, total fare paid. I'm going to put that right there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to multi-select all three of these. We're going to look for that hidden property. It's this one right here. I'm going to hide those three and save this back to my model. Then we're going to go back to our report, refresh our report. And then what we're going to see that it's been moved to a measure table because the only thing that's there is measures. So easy. Now I want to show you one more thing. And the reason I opened up Tabular Editor 3, because maybe you have multiple measures and maybe you're copying these or migrating this from another model. How could you create multiple measures in one swoop and publish them out? So in Tabular Editor 3, go here, and then I'm going to say model. I can say script DAX, or I can go here, new DAX query. So I'm going to show you, right? If I do model, script DAX, there's no DAX there. Let me refresh this schema. All right, so I'll do a quick refresh. And so you can see there's my measure there. So I'm going to close this. And then what I'm going to do is say model script DAX. And you can see there's my one measure. Okay, it's already created. I don't want to recreate that one. I already wrote a script to create 3 new ones. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, paste this on here. And now all I need to do is click this run button or press F5, and it's going to apply it to my model. So I do that. You can see the measures are there. And then I'm going to go ahead and click save everything back. All right, it saves everything back to my model. Go back over here, click refresh, go here. Now you can see all my measures. Not only can I connect with all these other tools, DAX Studio to do some performance tuning, Visual Studio to do some development, APIs, I can integrate with DevOps and Git to do CI/CD. I can do development right in Tabular Editor. This is bananas. All right, what do you think? Have you tried this out? Have you enabled the XMLA read-write endpoint for your Fabric workspaces and your Direct Lake datasets? I'd love to know. If you run into challenges, you have any comments, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you want to know more about Fabric, check out this playlist flying over my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.